It's back to the action and excitement of the South African Grand Prix at Kyalami, brought to you by Techniques, leaders in high-performance hi-fi.
En welkom terug. Jy sal waarskynlik onthou dat in Australië verlede jaar die laaste wedren van die seisoen was dit 'n absolute fiasco geweest met die reën wat afgekom het in die hele wedren. Die wedren is na 16 ronde stop gesit. Nigel Mansell het nie die wedren voltooi nie. So ook nie Gerhard Berger nie. Ayrton Senna het ook daardie wedren gewen. Maar soos wat ons gehoor het, die kampioenskap was natuurlik reeds verby in Japan. So dit is in hakies die hoogtepunte wat ons vir die nou gewys het uit die 1991 seisoen is geneem uit die amptelike visa oorsig van die 1991 seisoen getiteld Nelly Mansell. Is 'n volle 3.5 uur se aksie van die 1991 seisoen en u kan dit natuurlik ook by Topsport bemarking kry. U moet maar net skakel tydens kantoorure. U ken waarskynlik al reeds daardie nommer. Die volgende op ons program is die plaaslike sterre reeks, maar ons gaan eers vir u vinnig wys wat is die tye waar u kan inskakel môre en ook Sondag op Tv1 wanneer ons vir u nog verder hoogtepunte van Kyalami afbring. So maak gerus 'n nota hiervan sodat u nie vergeet om te kyk na die oorskakels wat ons vir u bring. Môre op TV1 tussen 7:00 en 9:00 in Goeiemôre Suid-Afrika verskeie oorskakelings van Kyalami af met 'n klomp interessanthede, al die agtergrond en dinge wat hier in die gang is op Kyalami. Tussen 3:30 en 4:10 môre middag gaan ons ook vir die hoogtepunte bring van die kwalifiserende rondes en so ook tussen 5:00 en 5:45 en dan Sondag natuurlik die groot dag. Ons eerste oorskakeling daar is tussen 10:00 en 11:00. Wedren begin om 2:00, so ons gaan reeds van 1:00 af Sondagmiddag vir die opbou bring en ons is op die lug tot om 5:00 Sondagmiddag. Nou die wedren begin om 2:00 en sal waarskynlik tot so 4:00 se kant duur. Nou ja, die volgende op ons program is die TV1 Topsport sterre reeks, die eerste wedren van hierdie jaar se reeks en dit is 'n reeks waarin daar bekendes uit die vermaaklikheidswêreld, die sportwêreld en die nuuswêreld gaan deelneem om aan mekaar teen mekaar te jaag in almal in standaard produksiemotors Toyota Conquest modelle. En die manne wat vir ons hierdie wedren gaan beskryf is ou vriend Roger McCleary en Graeme Cooper.
Thanks very much indeed, Hendrik. Well, they're just getting a little bit of practice in at the moment. This is the first look these drivers have of looking at this Grand Prix circuit. They actually set their grid on the mid-vol circuit because, of course, Kyalami's been used for Grand Prix practice, etc. So they're giving them one or two laps, and then we're going to get down to the action. It's going to be a five lapper. That's just over 21 kilometers this race, and we've brought together a real celebrated field of talent here, starting with Sean Marshall, who's the cyclist, of course, and they've always done very, very well in this type of racing. He'll be in car number one. Then Johan Lamprecht from Northern Transvaal, one of the Blow Buller, is going to be out there as well. Tony Johnson, the golfer, he just loves it. He actually flew back from overseas to be part of the final last year. And then we've got the motoring editor of the Citizen, that's Andre de Kock, who's going to fly the flag for the Citizen newspaper. Always puts together a very, very good supplement indeed. And that, I think, is the end of practice. That is their look-see they're going to have at the circuit. Then we've got Stuart Hailstone, South African squash champion. He's in car number five. We're going to see him a little bit later. And then very nice to welcome boxing personality and champion and trainer of Brian Mitchell, that's Harold Folbrecht. Ferdy de Vos, the motor editor or assistant motor editor of the Bielt, he's in car number eight. And then we've got our old friend Arnold Geertz. Arnold Geertz, we've seen him at the, there it is. Arnold Geertz, you can see he's fourth on the grid at the moment. And then we have down in the field as well, Francois Meyrung. He's the Northern Transvaal rugby player as well, as is Adrian Richter in the field as well. And then Kefi van der Merwe, he's the only Transvaal rugby player against all those Blow Buller. But it's nice to see Sean Marshall, the cyclist who always do well in these races, up at the top of the grid. Now with me in the commentary box, Graeme Cooper, your favourites here, Graeme.
Ja nee, Roger, is maar baie, baie moeilijk om hier een speciale persoon uit te kies. Natuurlijk die TV1 Topsport wedren voor bekende personen. En zoals je gezegd hebt, ons het boxers hier, ons het mensen wat fietsry. Ons het rugbyspelers, golfers en manne wat vir ons die koerante skryf en allerhande sulke dinge by mekaar. En dan is natuurlik nog die mense van die SAIK, Arnold Geertz. Ek het vroeger gehoor dat Marietta Kreer ook gaan ry, Roger. Ek weet nie of sy op die wegspring rooster is nie. Maar dit lyk my op die voorste posisie daar, Sean Marshall, wat die voorste wegspring posisie het. En soos Roger vroeger gesê het, die mense wat in hierdie wedren gaan deelneem het nie baie kans gehad om kennis te maak met hierdie renbaan. Hulle het basies een ronde gery nou en hulle sal nog een opwarmingsronde gegun word net om hulle self bietjie meer te orienteer met hierdie nuwe Kyalami renbaan en dan sal die ligte van rooi na groen gaan. Natuurlik die wedren sal dan aanwees en dan sal ons maar sien hoe hierdie Toyota Conquest RS motortjies lyk na hierdie wedren. Roger, ek is seker daar gaan 'n paar van hulle wees moet 'n bietjie duike en stampe instote baie na aan die Stanik groep en spesifikasies natuurlik. En soos jy kan sien, die motortjies regtig baie mooi geverf en met verskillende plakkers en so aan bedek om hulle baie mooi te laat lyk. Ons sien vir Johan Lambrecht bietjie verder daar agter F.A. Meyring. Dit is die man in die tweede posisie wat ons nou net daar gesien het. En het lyk vir my hulle is so te sê reg, ons sou die baanfiskale dop en die motortjie wat voor hulle gaan neem hulle nou vir nog 'n ronde om die baan om vir die laaste keer gewoon te raak aan die baan. Dan is dit eintlik 5 rondes van groot sports, Roger.
Well, that's quite a business for them to have so little practice on the circuit because it is a very fast circuit indeed with some very hairy corners, could we say. That the venture that you're seeing in front of this field is a very hot one. It's a one-off. It's got a big motor in there. Lots of tuning has gone into this venture, and that is the one that is leading this pack of cars around. There are 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 of them. 5 will go forward to the final on Sunday, and then from Sunday, 2 will remain and will go into the final at the end of the year. So there's going to be 6 races overall in the series, with 12 cars competing at the German Touring Car Race at the end of the year. We can expect some hairy things here if they haven't gone around the circuit quickly, but they have been trained by the Kyalami Speed International Racing School, so they've shown them the absolute basics of motor racing, gear changing, your line through the corners, and this must help all these drivers. But it looks pretty simple out there, but once you're in those motor cars on this big wide track with these fast corners, the whole thing takes on a totally new picture. But if you haven't been to Kyalami before, it's a beautiful looking circuit. I've never seen it look better. As we go around budget corner, that's a right hander. Let's just show you the circuit if you're seeing us for the first time. And Ayrton Senna will be going around this corner here, 240 kilometers an hour at the Yellow Pages Grand Prix. So they break down to 100 kilometers an hour as they go around the Yellow Pages corner. That's a famous one now, 90 degree left hander. And the Grand Prix car is just a little touch on the pedal and they are through here. And we'll be discussing some of their times. Of course, Nigel Mansell way on his own at the moment. He's leading everybody else by more than 1 second. So he's done a tremendous job here in official practice this afternoon, followed by Berger and by Senna. Then we get into the Topsport S's with a lot of runoff area. This has all been increased over the 18 weeks that they have been preparing the circuit for the Grand Prix. And they climb up the famous Winfield Hill up to West Bank Corner. And that is, you arrive on this shelf, you see them come up there absolutely blind and then onto the brake markers there. As I say, that's the Venture taking them around in front of a very hot one, 2.2 litre motor, and it's been tuned for the occasion. Richard Leake, the international rally navigator, he's at the controls of this Toyota Venture. Right, they come down. This is known as the IGI mine shaft. It's unique in the world as a mine shaft. And they come whistling down here absolutely flat out until they take the left-hander down at IGI, going absolutely full bore. The braver ones take it full bore. Some of the not-so-brave start to tap off. This is a new corner at Continental now. Continental tyres, of course, it's slower than it looks. It's been catching out a lot of the Grand Prix drivers. Berger was caught out there a little bit earlier. It's spun into the kitty sand and was left with his wheels just turning, grinding away in the sand. He couldn't get out until he was helped by these excellent marshals. Here's one that is flat out in a Grand Prix car, the new Caltex turn. It's a right-hander, and the lovely view as they come under the bridge there into Caltex corner, and then the final corner on the circuit, and this is the brilliant sign corner. It's almost a hairpin, very slow. It's another one that's been catching the drivers out, and they come out, accelerate out of this corner very quickly indeed. Well, they'll be taking up their grid positions now. On the front row of the grid, we've got numbers 1 and number 11, and that's Sean Marshall on pole position. Number 11 is Francois Meyring. And then in the second row, just nudging forward, there's Harold Folbrecht. Just decides he wants to get a lot closer to the man in front of him. And then we've got Arnold Gitz. Arnold has been waving to friends and fans now since he got into that motor car. sitting there smiling, enjoying himself. But this is going to be heavy now. Five laps of this race as the way they get going. Nice start by all of them. Andre de Kock is right at the back of this field. He's in car number four. We'll see a little bit of him a little bit later. As they squeeze, they go down through total curve, through a right-hander here, and then they go through this left-hander. This is a very dangerous part of the circuit as they go through total and then start climbing up the hill towards Nasha, and already Sean Marshall is starting to take control of this race. Watch Andre de Kock. He's moved already up four positions, and I should imagine he'll be with this leading pack. He's already into fourth position. There he is in shot now, leading this whole big pack through here, and we'll be picking him up. Of course, he's keeping the honor of the Guild of Motoring Journalists, their flag flying, and we're going to see more of him in this race. It's Marshall in the front at the moment. Second man along there is Francois Meyrung. So we've got a cyclist from the Northern Transvaal leading a fellow Northern Transvaaler, Francois Meyrung. The only man, as I say, flying the flag for Transvaal Rugby is Katie van der Merwe, as they do heavy braking down. These are brand new conquests in this new livery. Just gingerly finding their way through there. Number eight is Ferdy de Vos. He's the assistant motoring editor of the Bilt. And then we've got Arnold Goetz in there fighting it out with them. Nice aerial shot of Kyalami. They go down through the Topsport S and start climbing up this hill with that kink in the middle. That's the Winfield Hill as they go up the hill. It's a very steep one. And certainly cyclists will know just how steep it is. They go onto that shelf at the top. It's nicely shown there. And then the braking all takes place on that little straight part before they go into the double left-hander at West Bank Corner. Marshall is starting to walk away as Andre de Kock is looking for his third position. It's Marshall in front. Then it looks like it is number 11 is Francois Meyrung next. There's Andre de Kock starting to move up a little bit closer as they come down the hill. It's Harold Folbrecht in third position, followed by Andre de Kock. So the order is Marshall, it's Meyrung, it's Harold Folbrecht, and the fastest man so far, and just taking them in the inside. He's and he causes an absolute mayhem as he comes to Conti Corner, is Andre de Kock. Fine driver, of course, he's known as the fastest passenger in the world, having been strapped to a jet engine dragster. Stuart Marshall just cleaning up on his own, but here's the man who's going to give chase. He did nearly 400 kilometers an hour, did Andre de Kock, strapped to the engine of a jet dragster at the Tarleton Raceway. But here they come. It's Marshall as they come through the start finish, end of lap one. Andre de Kock has pushed his way right from the back of the field into second position. Then we've got number 11, and that's Francois Meyrung. Number 7 is Harold Folbrecht. He's close by there. And this is developing into a very nice little battle there for second, third, fourth, and fifth. De Kock coming through now. Then it's Marshall. It's Folbrecht coming up in the inside there. Just catch hold of his number. That's F.A. Meyrung. Francois Meyrung has come through in the inside. That's the order at the moment. We finished lap one, and they are trying very, very hard indeed in these Toyota Conquest. Little 1600cc, 16-valve four-cylinder engines.
Well, yeah, Roger, ik is zeker dat Sean Marshall uitgevind het dat die Toyota Conquest baie, baie vinniger is as sy racies fiets. En een lekker tweestrijd wat daar aangaan op die oomblik, nummer 8. En dat is Ferdy de Vos, wat sy pad natuurlijk ook begin oopvecht daar naar voren toe. Dit is dan, dit lyk vir my, die Citizen in die Beeld wat vandag nog ook 'n groot stryd hier aan mekaar gaan wen. En natuurlik aan die voorte, Sean Marshall en Andre de Kock wat nou baie, baie hard. Ja, Ferdy de Vos lyk vir my deur na die derde posisie toe. Hier sien ons vir Andre de Kock in die rooi motor, dan is het Ferdy de Vos. Hulle is besig om deur die Topsport S te gaan, baie, baie moeilike draai. Dit lyk makkelijk uit die ligheid, maar hy is geweldig skerp en mens moet precies die rechte lijn neem. Deur die eerste S, deur die eerste linkerhand te draai. Dit lyk vir my nommer 4 daar, so dis Andre de Kock. Andre de Kock het getol en daar word hy geslaan van die kant af. Andre de Kock word gestamp daar ek door motor nommer 3. Dit is Tony Johnston. Tony Johnston wat hom van die kant af slaan. Lyk my Andre de Kock bietjie hard probeer. Ons sien die geel vlag deur die baanbeamptes. Andre de Kock probeer om daar uit te ry. Toe hy raak gery was daar, het ons net sien glaspad. En hy, soos Roger sê, hy noem dit die kitty litter. Regtig sit ons man daar, Andre de Kock, redig vast daar so, en as geen manier wat hy op die stadium daar gaan uitkom nie. Sean Marshall hoort by die tyd al te besef dat dit nie meer vir hom so groot bedreiging gaan wees deur Andre de Kock nie, want hy sit redig lekker vast. Ons gaan nou sien wat ons baanbeamptes daar, Tony Johnston wat hom daar geslaan het, en ons kan sien hoe die voorste gedeelte van die motor redig beskadig is. Dit is Andre de Kock wat hom daar verloor het, probeer weer terugkom op die baan. Hy het natuurlijk getol by die tweede S. En oopsie, dis waar dit gebeur. Sien hoe Spat die glas gelukkig het in die gerol nie. Dit is by die tweede S. Andre moes beslis gekyk het daar voordat hy oor die baan gekom het. Daar was nog motors wat in die ander motors wat ook in die wedren is. Roger, hier kyk ons nou kyk weer deur die tweede S soos ek vir gesê het. Die baanleiding moet baie baie mooi gekies word as jy deur die Topsport S gaan. Glad nie maklik nie. Sien hoe staan hy daar, stil een van die ander motors kom verby. Kry hom weg en dan kyk, die kom die een motor bietjie te vinnig daarso en maak ongelukkig kontak daar. So hierdie twee motors uit die wedren uit, maar natuurlik die res van die wedren gaan nog steeds voort. Sean Marshall nog steeds aan die voortou, laat ons net sien optel hierso. Nou natuurlik Ferdy de Vos, Roger, is 'n man wat gaan nader begin skuif en miskien sal hy dan bietjie vir Sean Marshall later in hierdie wedren 'n bietjie meer van 'n harde tyd kan gee.
Well, he's flying the flag now under the cock. It's a bit of a stupid thing to do to be stuck in the infield, come right across the road, and Tony Johnson had no chance then, just slammed into the side of him. Lots of glass going everywhere. So the order we've got at the moment, walking away with his race, is the cyclist, that's all they seem to do. We had Anton Oberholzer doing it before, and then he did very well in the final. In fact, he's now into Stanek Group N racing and doing very well indeed, is Anton Oberholzer. Now this is the race going on now for fourth position. Number seven is Harold Folbrecht. And just on his tail, he's got Arnold Geertz, who's settling down to things now. We're into the third lap, halfway through this race, and they're having a real ding-dong, the two of them. This is where Andre de Kock went off in the second of the Topsport S's. Some of those marks show where he did it as they start climbing up those hills. And those are very potent little motor cars. There's the stricken citizen motor car of Andre de Kock. So Ferdy de Vos flying the flag there for the Guild of Motoring Journalists, or for the motoring fraternity. A little further back, we've got Hans Meyron, Harold Folbrecht, Arnold Geertz, and then we've got Johan Lamprecht going steadily, but this is a neck and neck tussle here. And Stuart Halston, he's lying in at the moment in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 position at the moment. And then just behind him, Adrian Richter, he comes next. And we've got Katie van der Merwe. And that is the entire order. Well, Stuart Marshall has come through with a huge lead here. But giving chase is Ferdy de Vos. He's not going to let him get away with it. There's these two others, 9 and 7. 9 is Arnold Geertz, 7 is Harold Folbrecht. So we've got the broadcasting community having it out with a very fine boxing trainer with a great reputation in the world. As they go neck and neck down here, they'll be doing 140, 150 kilometers an hour. Just to show you this line through the corner, they've done their three laps there. And this is where they might just touch the brakes as they go through the second of the total curves. Lovely shot. Start climbing up the hill to Nashua now. This is a tricky one. You start turning left here. As there you see them going. Now you've got to start braking and changing down as you've got the car all going sideways. And there he's losing it. And Harold Folbrecht has just lost it. And Arnold gets come screaming past. So Folbrecht has gone down a place.
That was a bit of a knock on the chin for him, wasn't it, Rog?
Right, so Ferdy de Vos is the hope of the motoring community to go and catch... is catch Sean Marshall. The order at the moment is Marshall. It is Ferdy de Vos in second position. And then we've now got Harold Folbrecht. No, Francois Meyron, then Harold Folbrecht. And Arnold Geertz is following up at the moment.
Anyway, Roger, die eerste twee rondes het vir ons die meeste van die opwinning gegee. Skoot wat ons hier sien is bo van die Wesbank draai af. Dan gaan hier is nou weer die onder ons hier wat ons by Nashua draai, die eerste ingang by Nashua draai, en dan word dan soos Roger gesê het, skies toch gerem en deur die ratte verwissel, en kom ons kyk hoe word dit nie gedoen nie. Gelukkig word daar kop gehou, natuurlik die Formule 1 renjaars word dopgehou deur hierdie mense en leer om vinnig te reageer. Nommer 9 op skoot daar, dit is Arnold Geertz wat nog steeds hard veg. Hy word nou omtrent in die derde plek te wees of vierde plek, Roger.
He's going to back a place. He was the one that spun it now. But as he comes up the hill towards, that's Arnold Geertz. We've got a lap and a little bit to go as he comes up braking for West Bank Corner. Nicely turned out. We had that bang a little bit earlier as he accelerates out of West Bank Corner. and heads off down the hill. Ahead of him he's got Harold Folbrecht and Mayrum and Ferdy DeVos. They're all spread out around the circuit at the moment. And we've got a door open there. Car number two is Johan Lamprecht. Maybe that's for a quick exit in that motor car. There's the leader. That's the cyclist, making no mistakes about it. Here he comes out of Nashua Corner now and comes towards us. Watch him come over the brow of the hill. This is our leader, and he's got a very, very big lead indeed. He's leading by something like 15 seconds at the moment. He's just taken this race and set off. He was on pole position. He's made no mistake about it. And there he is out on his own. As we come down, that's Sean Marshall going into Yellow Pages. Well, we've had that excitement with Andre de Kock taking out Tony Johnson. We've had Harold Folbrecht spinning it around there. Arnold Geertz getting past him. And this is the leader coming through the second of the Topsport S's. On the climb that hill. Very lively little motor car is this Toyota Conquest. And this is the first round of the TV1 Top Series, as we've got number 8 going off, Ferdy DeVos, trying very, very hard as he get it going again. That's in the second of the Topsport S's, and he got away with that one pretty lightly.
Wel, hierdie keer het hy natuurlijk in sy drie spieeltjies gekyk, Roger, en seker gemaakt dat niemand daar opgedacht. Hier is het ons een skoot van motor nummer 11. En het lijkt mij zoals Eva Meijering is recht vinnig daar gezien het, Roger. En so'n bietjie stif vinnig in die draai ingegaan. Je weet, die bande is niet zo breed dat mens die enige snelheid daar kan ingaan. Die Sean Marshall, die man wat voortloop op hierdie stadium. Die wedren van die begin tot aan die einde, Roger, absoluut in sy beheer gehad. En so het die manne wat om probeer jagen natuurlijk van die baan afgeval. En hier is het, dit is natuurlijk die laatste ronde, die geruite vlag boord voor hem te wachten. Die laatste draai naar links, voor hij in die pijlvak inkom. Door die Formule 1 kuipen voorbij. En een man wat zeker baie trots is op homself. Ons wacht net voor die geruite vlag en dan gaan dit. Daar is die geruite vlag nou ook gereed. En Sean Marshall, die fietsrijder, wat dan hierdie eerste been van die TV Topsport wedren voor bekende personen ben vandaag. En die tweede plek, wat ons het gesien het, was ja, dan steeds Ferdy DeVos, wat tweede by ons voorbij kom. Motorskrywer. En nou wag ons net vir die derde motor wat kom. Dit behoort F.A. Meiring te wees, die rugby speler van Noord-Transvaal. Soos Roger vroeg gesê, die hele helfte van die Noord-Transvaal span was omtrent vandag in hierdie wedren gewees. En is nou in die pijlvak af op pad na die geruite vlag toe. Dit dan die derde positie, Harold Folbrecht, behoort baie, baie nabij achter hom te wees. Dus nummer 7 net achter hem, Harold Folbrecht, wat hier Arnold Geertz gejaagd wordt. En dan natuurlijk Lambrecht, wat in die 6e positie op hierdie stadium geëindig het.
Right, this is some of the action that you're seeing at Kyalami. Of course, we're giving you a lot more Grand Prix action from Kyalami. But in the meantime, let's just go back to the studio.